Okay, Shannon, this was your second speech. You organized your speech, and you told me in an email or in our email correspondence that you were having trouble figuring out how to get that speech in a good organized format. And I offered to you what I think everybody here in Toastmasters knows: say what you're going to say, say it, tell everybody what you just said. So I wasn't really sure that you were able to get that into your speech in the short amount of time that you had from when you initially began writing it till now. But first one thing I want to talk about is some of the things that you do well. So for your second speech, to not be able to stand up here without any notes is very promising. So I think that as you move forward in Toastmasters, that will it's a good stepping stone to have. Secondly, I think that you did a good job with your hand gestures, so your body language and your gestures and your vocal variety is really good. So from what I saw, there's a really good foundation to become a really good speaker. The difficulty I think that you struggled with in this speech might have been understanding of maybe how to write the speech. So what I would like to do now is just kind of give you an idea of what maybe good crafting of the speech would be, for this speech. So this speech that you initially talked about how you worked overnight, and so you have a hard time getting catching up on your sleep, which I think I can understand. My mom worked nights when I was growing up, and she was asleep all day long. But I think that could be a really good introduction, especially if you turn it into a joke. Oftentimes, especially at meetings that are 7 o'clock in the morning, people complain about how early they had to get up to get here. Well, how do you think I feel? I've been up since 10 o'clock last night working, toiling at work. So that would be a really good introduction to start your speech. The second part of your speech, the story that you told about your son graduating and you feeling that you were running out of time to mold him into a young man. I think anybody who has children who experiences that. My daughter just left for Louisiana on Monday, and it's like, oh my God, she's grown up. So that you can create that into another separate little story. So as you're crafting your speech, you take these little stories, and those are segments of the speech. The introduction, a couple of stories to segment it, and to be your body, and then finally, you wrap them all up together with your message in the conclusion. And I think if you can practice doing that going forward, then you'll become an outstanding speaker. Thank you.